There was a time when Fernando Torres was considered as one of the best strikers in the world. Whenever he played, it felt like he would never fail to score, capturing the hearts of fans worldwide. But all of a sudden, just like that, it seemed like he lost everything. What's up guys, it's Raymar back again for another video, and today, we're gonna look at what happened to Fernando Torres' career. Torres would begin his football journey in Atletico Madrid's youth program. Believe it or not, Torres actually started off his football career as a goalkeeper, but after his touch and control was noticed, his coach said it would be a waste of his talents to rot away at the goalpost. Torres was just 16 when he broke into Atletico Madrid's first team. He was so young and promising, which led to everyone in the team feeling threatened by him. Since they didn't know his name, they started calling him El Niño, which in Spanish means the kid. As a young prodigy for the club, Torres would make his official debut for the men's team in 2002, scoring a respectable 20 goals in 35 appearances. That season, Torres would be La Liga's third highest scorer and would be named Atletico Madrid's captain only at the age of 19. Which is honestly pretty insane. Becoming a captain only at his teenage years, even though there were so many senior players on the squad, was pretty much unheard of. He was the kid captain learning from the older players, so the nickname El Niño just stuck with him. Also, on a side note, Torres has said that he actually hates the nickname El Niño associated with him, but it's kinda too late for that now as it's become such an iconic part of his career. After the season, Chelsea owner and billionaire Roman Abramovich made a little glimpse of the hype that was surrounding El Niño just after his very first La Liga season. The following season, Torres would have a taste at his very first European competition, the UEFA Cup. Torres would help his team reach the final, scoring 3 goals in 5 appearances, but as luck would have it, they would lose the final in a 3-1 penalty shootout against fellow La Liga rivals Villarreal. In 2007, teams from the Premier League began making moves to try and sign the Spanish striker, with Liverpool and Chelsea nearly going all out in order to try and acquire him. In the end, Liverpool gave Atletico Madrid an offer that was too good to refuse, a 25 million euro transfer fee and a deal between Villarreal to send Diego Forlan to Atletico in exchange for Luis Garcia. And with that deal, Fernando Torres would be headed to Anfield. This move seemed to be perfect for Liverpool, as just on his debut, Torres would score his first Premier League goal, giving the home fans a taste of what was to come. Just a month later, Fernando Torres would score his very first hat-trick in the Premier League against Reading. Torres would continue his scoring and amaze everyone, winning him his first Premier League Player of the Month award after scoring 4 goals in 4 consecutive appearances. In fact, Torres became the first Liverpool player to score successive home game hat-tricks since Jack Balmer in 1946, which was more than half a century ago. Torres would also eclipse Ruud van Nistelrooy's record for most debut Premier League goals scored in a single season from a foreign player, and finished second to Emmanuel Adebayor in the race for the Premier League Golden Boot. In his first season with Liverpool, Torres would score 33 goals in 46 appearances, making it the most goals scored by a player in a single season for the club, passing Michael Owen's previous record of 29 goals. This amazing season would also land Torres in the shortlist for the PFA Player of the Year award, which was won by Cristiano Ronaldo. He would also finish second in the PFA Young Player of the Year award, which was won by fellow Spaniard Cesc Fabregas. Again, Chelsea attempted to sign Torres, but this time it was for a fee of £50 million. But Liverpool co-owner Tom Hanks denied it, saying he would not allow him to leave the club for any price. The following summer, Torres was also called to join the Spanish men's team for the 2008 European tournament, and helped them win the title by assisting and scoring in 1 goal. The very next season, Torres would be named into his first FIFA World 11, finish 3rd place behind Ronaldo and Messi in the FIFA World Player of the Year award, and be named into his 2nd consecutive PFA Team of the Year. Another interesting fact is that just on his 2nd season with the club, Torres was named into Liverpool's 50 Greatest All-Time Players. In 2010, it would be Torres' last season in perfect health. He would score 22 goals in 33 appearances, becoming the fastest Liverpool player to ever score 50 goals, being selected into his second FIFA World 11 squad and finishing as Liverpool's top scorer again before he had to undergo knee surgery after an injury he received against Benfica that would end his season early. That summer, Torres was called up to be included in the 2010 Spanish squad for the World Cup. But despite his injury and Liverpool staff advising him not to go, he still decided to do it. He would end up not scoring and playing very minimal minutes, but they would still go on to win their country's very first World Cup. Now, you guys have probably heard this multiple times when I make these types of videos about different players, but I just have to make this very clear. Knees are very important when playing football. Every injury affects a player's speed and form, and this is exactly what happened to Fernando Torres, especially because he didn't even give it proper time to heal when he went to play in the World Cup, instead of focusing on rehabilitation. Ever since his surgery, Torres never really got back to his legendary form for Liverpool. The next season, Torres would have his worst performance for the club, scoring 9 goals in 22 appearances, which isn't terrible at all, but it seemed like Torres was a ghost of his former self. This time, Chelsea would finally get to have the player that they've been trying to sign for years. In 2011, Torres would move to Stamford Bridge for a fee of £50 million, which back then was considered a ton of money, being unable to score a goal. Chelsea fans made it very clear that they were disappointed in Torres and regret having gotten him. But little did they know that in the next season, Torres would make them eat their words. In 2012, Torres would only score 11 goals in 49 appearances, which was very underwhelming again, but everyone would forget about his poor form when it came to one of the most Mets hoping for a miracle to happen. Barcelona was only a few minutes away from beating Chelsea and advancing to the final. But in stoppage time, Fernando Torres somehow manages to break free from every Barcelona defender and just pass through Victor Valdez with ease, scoring one of the most clutch and iconic goals in Champions League history. That one goal erased all the doubt and hate that Chelsea fans had towards him, with critics even saying that he paid back his £50 million transfer fee with that goal alone. So with that, Chelsea would move on to the final and eventually win their first ever, scoring 4 goals in total and again helping his home country Spain win their second European championship, being the first ever national team to win consecutive Euros with a World Cup title in between. As for club play, Torres would score 22 goals in 64 appearances for Chelsea. After that season, we would never really see Torres have the same goal scoring output as he once did. As you can see, he's never scored over 20 goals in a single season again. After leaving Chelsea, Torres would hop around, being loaned to different teams like AC Milan and even his former club Atletico, until they officially re-signed him for a couple of years in 2016. And to be fair, Torres was still getting some decent goal-scoring production during those years after Chelsea. It just wasn't nearly as impressive as he used to do. And it's weird, but I've been seeing comments about Torres on some videos and people seem to think he's retired. But he's actually playing for Sagan Tosu in the Japanese league, along with fellow Spaniard Andres Iniesta. So they still have some miles left on their legs. So far for Sagan Tosu, Fernando Torres has scored a total of 2 goals within 12 appearances. So hopefully we can still see some of that good old Fernando Torres in Japan, because watching him in his prime was an absolute pleasure, as he was one of my favorite players growing up just because of how good yet humble he was. But regardless, I wish Torres the best of luck because he is getting older and is probably gonna retire in a few years. So I thank him for being able to witness his play. Anyways, that's pretty much gonna do it for me, guys. I did get a new microphone and change the background music, so let me know what you think about it in the comments section below to help support my channel. Also, sorry for not uploading in a while. I've just been so busy with school and I'm trying to get consistent next one.